Hi people, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and in this video I'm going to analyze the NTA UGC NET Paper 1 which was conducted on 26th of June in the first shift. So the reason why I'm analyzing this paper is because I teach my students English literature and the students who appeared for English literature had their paper on one day, one single day, that was 26th of June and that too in the first shift. So I am going to look at the entire paper 1 and I'm going to analyze and put in front of you what all things you need to keep in mind if you are going to prepare and appear for December 2019 exam and how you should strategize and how you should prepare a blueprint for your preparation looking at the paper pattern. So we are going to look at all the 10 units one by one. So stay tuned to this channel and also watch this video till the end. So let's begin by first looking at the time. So this time there was a huge advantage for the NET aspirants because they were given 3 hours together for both paper 1 and 2 and it was up to them how much time they would like to devote for any of these papers. So there was no time crunch. So students were able to complete the paper in a very relaxed manner. Kisi ka bhi paper chhuta nahi. So that was a big thing. Another important thing was that the paper was really simple. Like maine jitne bhi students se baat kari hai, everybody was of the opinion that paper bahut simple tha and if they have watched my videos, the crash course videos which I have uploaded on my YouTube channel for UGC NET Paper 1, you could have seen that the topics which I have talked about in the crash course video, exactly from those topics questions were coming. So kuch bhi out of syllabus, out of blue nahi aaya tha. The paper was very decent, even the calculations part was very less. So there were times where you can even calculate in your mind. The calculations were so simple that you don't need to even use a pen and paper. That is what students have reported so far. Let's begin with the first area, that is DI, the most horrifying area. DI ki jahan tak baat kari jaye, so DI bahut simple aaya tha. Students reported that jo figures the that were in like round numbers, okay, round numbers as in they were rounded off. So 20, 15, 115, is type ki figures se, to calculations karna bahut simple raha. Okay, so one of the students reported that the fraction was somewhere 31 upon 67. So is type ke figures mein answers the. So it becomes very easy for students to calculate because they don't need to multiply it by 100 and then calculate the percentage. You can just do minimum calculations and you can get the answer. Another topic from which they were asking questions was research. As I've already mentioned in my research video on YouTube, that they most of the time ask questions from either the types of research or they ask from types of sampling. So this time the question was from types of sampling and you had to choose which of the following were the non-probability sampling, and one of the options as you all know would have been snowball sampling. So that was another area from which very simple questions were asked. Next unit was computers and information technology. From computers also this time no binary to decimal or decimal to binary questions were asked. They were asking very simple terms like SMTP, what's the full form, simple mail transfer protocol. Then there was a question that you had to convert KB into bytes. Okay, so how many bytes are going to be there in a kilobyte? So that was a conversion question that was asked. Now when we come to the next portion, that was teaching aptitude. From teaching aptitude, again very simple questions were asked. You were just asked about characteristics of teacher or you were asked about what a teacher is going to do in this particular situation. So very common sense based questions were being asked. So you don't need to worry at all about the theoretical portions. We are going to definitely come to the mathematical and logical reasoning and see if they were as simple as the theoretical ones. But let's first look at the theory questions. Now the next topic is reading comprehension. From reading comprehension, again the students reported that a very simple reading comprehension was given, okay, in which direct questions the sare, all the 5 questions were direct. There were no inference or theme based questions. You just need to read the paragraph and then you could just answer the question. Students also reported that earlier when they gave the NET exam in the month of December, they faced this issue that they had to scroll left and right and both up and down in order to answer a question, which was very frustrating. Of course, this time they made some changes in the system and it was more user friendly, more computer friendly. So now they had to just scroll left and right. They don't have to scroll up and down. The question was placed in the right hand side of the passage. So passages there there, and on the right hand side you have the question. So it's in front of you. You don't need to really panic in order to look at the passage and then look at the question. There was a good news for students who are not so good at current affairs, because this time two sections from which most of the time they ask current affair based question, the questions were relatively very easy. So the two sections definitely are government and higher education and people and environment. From government and higher education, they were not asking questions from government, from the parliament and the people involved in the parliament. They were rather asking questions from UGC. So the questions were focusing on UGC's primary goal, primary objective, primary function. The next topic is people and environment, from where they were asking really, really simple questions. Even though if you don't have good knowledge about this topic, you can use a common sense and answer questions. For example, they were asking that out of the four forms of energy, which one will produce the electric power in the fastest way. So there are options like nuclear and geothermal and solar and wind. So it's a very simple thing. You can actually very well relate that which is going to give away the power more easily, or which is going to convert to electrical energy more easily. Now, the next question that was asked from people and environment was Montreal Protocol. Montreal Protocol was signed between a few countries, and what is this Montreal Protocol all about? Another interesting question that was asked from people and environment was the reason why Taj Mahal is corroding so much. Okay, so the problem that lies with Taj Mahal is that because of pollution, it is now, the state of Taj Mahal is deteriorating day by day. So the question asked that which is the pollutant because of which the state is depleting of Taj Mahal. So that was the kind of questions asked from people and environment. When it comes to mathematical reasoning, it was surprising to see the kind of questions they asked. Very simple questions. No number series question, no direction based question, no blood relation question. Very simple question. Alphabet coding, decoding questions were there. Also, students reported that they found a question very tricky that was about profit. So it was given that the profit has decreased by 25% and the cost price was increased by 175 rupees, and then a selling price was given, so you had to calculate the cost price. So a kind of confusing question. A few students reported that that's the only question where they got stuck. Otherwise, the mathematical reasoning paper, the mathematical reasoning portion was very simple and very decent. Finally, we come on to the last area, that is the logical reasoning. Now, logical reasoning also had a very, very simple questions this time. So it was reported that there were questions on Venn diagram. There was a question on square of opposition, and both these questions were very simple. So even square of opposition question was very direct, and Venn diagram question was also something students could even do verbally. They did not even made a Venn diagram in order to understand it. So it was that simple. So overall, people reported that the paper was really decent. My advice to all the students who are going to appear for December 2019 exam is going to be that you have to now start focusing on the major areas from which repeated questions are being asked. So as I've already mentioned in most of my videos, that focus on previous year papers. Also, make sure that you watch my videos on crash course on paper 1. So there is a video series wherein I have discussed each and every unit in one video, and I have also talked about all the major portions that you must cover in that particular topic. So make sure you watch those crash course videos and start your UGC NET paper 1 preparation accordingly. So till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.